Therefore, now see, answer here in the mean is exact value we get. Therefore, based on that, what happened, answer in all the case, mean, median, mode, about the mean, about the median, about the mean, in all the case, we get same value. But in the mean, that give rise, sometimes we are not get the exact value. We get a what actually, we are round up to 4 decimal or 5 decimal value. That time we are take a difference. Take a different absolute difference of xi minus x bar, we get an error. Therefore, what I'm beginning I told, mean give rise more accurate compared to mean deviation about the mean, about the mode. But this is a thing we have to observe carefully. Here we get exact value mean, but you can't expecting always we get a mean must be exact value. Sometimes you get infinite number of decimal value, round up to how many? 2 or 3, because you are going to take a deviation. Once you round up, you take a deviation, definitely we get error. Therefore, we may be expecting error finding a mean deviation about the mean, about consider compared to median and mode. Are you clear? Yeah, beginning I told mean, but now observe this. Now immediately I think this mean don't get it accurate value. This has happened. Why? Because some case we get 1/3. Suppose we get a mean is equal to 1/3. Once you round up, we get what 0.33. We are taking 0.32 decimal. We are not taken all the infinite number of decimal. By doing a deviation, difference we get a error. Final calculation also we get a error. This is a thing we have to take care for finding a mean deviation about the mean. But the thing is not happen where median and mode. Are you clear? Now what they expecting based on that find out the mean deviation, but usually we are finding a mean deviation about the mean. But confidently I have to say that here mean deviation about the mean, we get accurate whenever mean must be a whole number or exact value. In other case, you can't expect it, we get an accurate value. I think it's clear how we get a values frequency distribution for discrete, about the mean, about the median, about the mode. I'm going to explain third case, whatever based on continuous frequency distribution. Find out mean deviation about the mean. First, you find out the mean. Here, before going whenever data in the form of masses are explained so many times, first you find the mid value. What's the mid value of 10 to 20? 15. No need I guess once again. 10 plus 20 divided by 2. That gives what about that 50? 20. 230 or 25. This is 35. This is 45. And this is 55. This is 65. This is what actually 75. Once we get this data, this is not a small data. Instead of go for a direct method, better I have to go for step deviation method. If you want to go for step deviation method, what is here is xi minus a divided by h. My a is nothing but what actually I told number of times, what's the maximum frequency after in the column? Frequency column is 14. What's the corresponding mid value is 45. Therefore, what is my a is 45. What is my h is 10, because each class is counted how many numbers. It's equal. And also explained previous classes for based on the mean. If you want to go for step deviation, data must be in the form of equal class interval. And then DI I'm going to calculate. What is my DI? 15 minus 45. What is 15 minus 45 is 30. Divided by 15 minus 45 is what actually minus 30. Divided by 10, what we get actually minus 3. Okay. 25 minus 45 is minus 20. Divided by 10 is minus 2. 35 minus 45 is minus 10. Is whatever divided by 10 is 1, minus 1. 45 minus 45 is 0. 55 minus 45 is 10. By 10 divided by 10, class interval is 10. 65 minus 20 divided by 10 is 2. 75 minus 35 is 30 divided by 10 is 3. Okay. Next, I have to calculate Fi into Di. My Fi Di is actually 2 into minus 3 is minus 6. 3 into minus 2 is minus 6. 8 into minus 1 is minus 8. Whatever this value 0. 8 into 1, 8. 6, 6. You take this total, you get 0 here. We get a 0. Once we get 0, you calculate what's the mean. What's the mean formula for step deviation? A plus of sigma fi di divided by sigma fi into the class interval. But here, x bar is nothing but 45 itself, because sigma fi di is what? 0. 0 divided by anything, non-zero value 0, into 10 also 0. Therefore, I am going to take what is my x bar is 45. Once we get x bar is 45, I have to calculate what's the mean deviations. Modulus of xi minus x bar. I have to calculate. Once you calculate, and also beta I have to multiply by, I have to do so many calculations. Therefore, I have to multiply the corresponding frequency also. Yes. What is absolute of xi minus x bar? 15 minus 45. What is 15 minus 45? You already know that minus 30. Minus absolute of that plus 30. We get 30 into 2 is 60. Okay. Next, 25 minus 45. What is 25 minus minus 20? Minus 20 is this is what actually minus 60. This also minus 60. This also minus whatever absolute I want to take. Sorry. This is plus 1. Okay. Next, 35 minus 45 is 10. Absolute of that is minus 10 is 10. 10 into 8 is 80. 45 minus 45 absolute is 0. 55 minus 45 absolute of 10 into 8 is 80. And next, 65 minus 45 is what we get actually. 20. 20 into this is 60. Again, 30 into 2 is 60. Take this sum, we get 400 for this. Once we get this 400, now I have to calculate immediately m dot d means mean deviation about x bar. About x bar means mean. It's nothing but sigma fi into absolute of xi minus x bar divided by total frequency. What is the sigma absolute? This value is 400 divided by total frequency is what actually? This total frequency. Yeah, to calculate here, I am neglecting to calculate because here it's a figure 0. Once you can add this value, this total we get 40. What we get actually? 10. The next, I'm moving to the second case, the finding based on the median. If you want to find out median from the class, also first you find out median class. If you want to find out median class, first you find out CF. First is cumulative frequency per class 2, second class is 5, the third class is 13, yes, next is 27, and next is 35, yes, next is what, 38, and then 40. You know that 40 is itself is a total of the given data, given class of the frequencies. And next, from the 40, what is capital N by 2? Capital N by 2 is nothing but 40 by 2. What is 40 by 2 is 20. 20 is what you know that which cumulative frequency just greater than 20 is 27. The corresponding class. What's the class? 40 into 50 is my median class. Now, this is exclusive class. Therefore, what's the formula for finding a median? L plus of N by 2 minus C divided by F into H. I am going to do a little bit fast because you already know that these steps. L is 40 plus N by 2 is 20 minus C. C is a frequency, cumulative frequency of the class preceding of the median class 13 divided by frequency of the median class is 14 into 10. You simplify that. This is thing. Now once you simplify 40, this is actually we get 70 divided by 14. What we get actually 45 we get. Here we get 45. Now once we get 45, not necessary to find out again fi into modulus of xi minus n. You observe this curve. What's the mean here? 45. Again if you take median also 45, we get same column of this column. 60, 60, 60 like that. I am not going to find out. Because same thing we get. As just like this, because x bar is nothing but my m also. Therefore, we get same thing. Now, I am not going to find out that column. Directly, I have to find out. We get, confidently say that mean deviation about the median. What's the formula? Sigma fi into absolute of xi minus m divided by total frequency. That value also itself is 10 because median also 45. Again, I have to take absolute difference. We get same value of each of the values of absolute of xi minus x bar into fi. Therefore, moving to the next one, third one. What's the third one? Based on the mode. Based on the mode, if you want to find out, also what's the maximum frequency of 14, the corresponding class is model class. Therefore, what is our model class? 40 to 50. What's the median formula? L plus of Fm minus F1 divided by Fm minus F1 plus Fm minus F2 whole multiple of this H. H is the class interval. What is my L is 40. What is my Fm? My frequency of the model class. What's the frequency of the model class? 14. What is my F1? Frequency of the preceding of the model class is 8. Before 14, 8. Following also 8. Just observe the table. 14 minus 8. Again F2 also 8. 14 minus 8. And then you multiply by H. It's 10. You simplify that. Finally we get the answer is what? 45 only. Already I have calculated. We get the answer is what actually? Mode also. Here also we get the answer is what actually? 45. Just you calculate this. Everything I substitute here. Okay. Once you get 45, again not necessary to prepare again fi into absolute of xi minus capital M. Because here also we get what's the value? 400. Therefore, based on the mean deviation about mode, also we get what's the answer is 10. Not necessary to calculate. I am trying to show that how to find out mean deviation about the mean, about the median, about the mode. I consider all the three cases. Without frequency, how to find out? With the frequency, there are two cases. One is discrete, another one is continuous. All the things I explained. Now, you take some more problems, but here we get in all that the same, but you can't expect in always you get the same. I told very clearly, whenever here in this case mean we get exact value. We can't expect in we get a mean exact value. Mode also we get, can't expect in exact value, especially for classes. And the given data in the form of classes are contained in frequency distribution. We can't expect a median, mean, and mode. It's supposed to be an accurate value. We can't expect an exact value or whole number. Sometimes we get a decimal value. Once you round up to the decimal value, we are finding a deviation. Definitely we get an error. You please try to understand that how much accuracy required based on that to find out the mean deviation, about the mean, about the median or mode. Means about the center, measure of center tendency. I think everyone is clear how to find out the mean deviation about the measure of center tendency. Thank you very much for listening my talk. Yeah, once again and to meet in my next class, measure of how to find out the next type is standard deviation, quotient of variation and variance.